Stable Diffusion XL has been released. Not the final version, of course, but almost 0.9. Some fortunate guys with good GPUs has already tested out, while others are probably still waiting in a queue for their prompts to be generated on a Clipdrop service. Today's video is for those who want to launch Stable Diffusion XL easily, quickly, and without any coding, literally in a couple of clicks, and of course, on any device. Time already got a lie, so today we will be using the tool, the holy grail in a world of free computing, Google Colab. This notebook launched Stable Diffusion XL in a ComfyUI, which doesn't look very friendly, to be honest, but in reality it is very simple, and we will cover everything you need to know for its basic usage. And yes, I struggled a lot to launch Automatic 1111, but I still haven't succeeded. However, I think I'll do that soon. So wish me luck, and for now, let's get started. As usual, open Google Colab Notebook using my link, which I leave in the description under this video. Then, extremely simply, just run this cell pressing this button. Now we're installing our requirements. It takes about 1 minute, very important information. There might be some problems with the downloading of the model, because in order to download the model, you need to pass some specific process or registration. I decided to simplify this process for you, so I downloaded a several version of the model to my personal repository, but I suppose that is not allowed on a Hugging Face. Maybe my repository will be deleted, quite possible, but at least for now it works. How to solve that problem, we discuss a bit later. As you can see, we just install all requirements, and all we need to do is just download our model. So press this button, download models. We're downloading true version of Stable Diffusion XL. Base version with 14 gigs, which is quite big, and smaller version, FP16. I explain why I decided to add two models. Here we go, our model downloaded successfully, and now let's run Stable Diffusion using step 3. Press this button once again, and we should wait. Here we go. We've got our URL, just follow this link, and we need to pass here our IP address. Pass it here, click to submit. We're in a ComfyUI interface. As I said before, its nose looks very friendly, but on a base level of usage is extremely easy. So there is several blocks. First one, it's a load checkpoint where you can choose your model. Extremely simply, choose your model 1 or model 2. Model 1, it's a base model XL, and smaller version of model, it's model 2. Then there is two blocks for prompt and negative prompt. As usual, almost the same like it works in Automatic 1111. Then there is some information about resolution and batch size. Now here is a sampler. In the case sampler, you can adjust some parameters, choosing steps, choosing SFG scale, sampling name. I think you already know what it is, because most likely you already seen that in Automatic 1111. There is nothing complicated. And final box, save image. That's it. If you make something wrong, I don't know, for some reason you just something crash and change some connection between box, add notes, I don't know, let's suppose this one and another one, you just need load default. That's it. You make something wrong, load default. Nothing special, nothing complicated, just load default. So let's test it out. Write our prompt. Once again, let's find something interesting in the CVTI. Let's take this one. We don't have lower model here, so we delete lower parameters, trigger words. Let's delete it. Here we go, we've passed our prompt here, and now we should just press this button, query prompt. We've got our result, and that is not so cool. For some reason, it not looks like a new Stable Diffusion XL model, and there is a problem. Why it just happened? The main problem that we didn't use our resolution, basic resolution of our model. It's a new model with a higher resolution, so we should choose a basic resolution of this model, which is 1024x1024. Query prompt, and let's see what we got here. As you can see, that looks way more better. That looks stunning, with exceptionally high resolution. That looks incredible. You need to know that it's just a base model. Yes, of course, there is might be some artifacts, but it's just a base model. In the near future, we can fix this using Dream Boost, LoRa models, control net, and fine-tuned models also. Oh yeah, that looks perfect. As I mentioned before, we downloaded two versions of Stable Diffusion. First one, it's a base version with a base resolution 10 1024x1024 pixels, and smaller version FP16 with basic resolution 512 and 512. Why I add two models? You know, in order to create best version of your image, I think you need to do that as much as possible. So the best workflow, to my mind, is to use model 2 FP16 with a lower resolution, and you'll get your result way more faster. And then, after getting specific result, you can apply your parameters with a proper specific seed to another model, to base model with a higher resolution, and that saves you a lot of time. If some problems happen here, and for some reason you can't download our model, as I said before, because I might be banned in a hacking phase, you should download your own model. How to do that? Very easy. If you find any link to a stable Diffusion XL model, that would be perfect. But for now, there is some problem to find direct link to a stable Diffusion XL model. So in order to get access to stable Diffusion XL, you need to open Hacking Face, search stability AI base model, path and version, and here you should sign up in order to get access. You already have account, so I just authorized. And then when you follow to this tab, you don't actually get access to your model because you need to sign up and provide stability AI by additional information about you. That's very easy. You can write any random information and just submit it only after, and you just need to copy link address here, pass it to my Google Colab notebook here in a step 2.1, and you need to pass your API token. How you can get your API? Very easy, just open your account settings here and then access token. You need to create new token and just copy them, pass it to Google Colab notebook. That's it. And after, you will be able to download any model you like. Thanks for watching. I hope that this video was helpful for you. Let me know if you have any problems, and see you.